It's lunchtime, and this is Brad Anderson's Lunch Break. Two of my favorite things about Microsoft are the smart people that constantly visit campus and the great fleet of shuttles. Whenever I can, I try to take advantage of both of these things and grab lunch with some of the tech industry's best and brightest. Today I'm driving around with Dr. Nicole Forsgren, a researcher, DevOps expert, and the CEO and chief scientist at DORA. How's it going, Nicole?
I'm good. Sweet minivan.
You know what? I wanted to harken back to the early days when we needed to have a minivan in order to put our kids in it. It's like a walk down memory lane here for me. In software, we're all about data and being able to use data to make decisions. And you've brought this uncanny academic rigor to how you use data. In fact, you have so much passion on this, you formed your own company.
Yes,
I love
that.
Tell us a little bit about the company, your background, and this passion on data.
Sure. So DORA is DevOps Research and Assessment. We've been doing research looking at how organizations can use so many fantastic capabilities to drive improvement in their ability to make software with both speed and stability.
Yep.
That's really the key central component in helping organizations perform amazingly well. And I say perform, so that's profitability, productivity, market share.
Yeah, so it's both internal and external, because a big part of perform is employee satisfaction, employee passion.
Also, decreasing deploy pain, decreasing burnout.
Okay, so we talk about this in-depth, you know, DevOps approach to IT and to dev. How does that impact morale?
When we study DevOps or technology transformations, we take kind of a holistic approach, and it includes culture, it includes technology, it includes agile and measurement, and the piece in agile includes how you develop software and team experimentation. And so the way it affects morale and team culture is we see greater communication, greater information flow, risks are shared, novelty is encouraged and implemented, morale is improved, and that ends up feeding through and having a positive impact on the entire organization's performance. For so long, I mean, have you heard before, you know, IT is a cost center.
Yeah.
IT is a cost center, right? Who's heard
that's
that?
It's definitely transition, but that's been the way it's been talked about for years.
And who's heard it so many times, right?
Tired of it.
But, right, seriously. But what we find is that it's really an investment. If you see it and if you view it as an investment, it pays back dividends tenfold, because it makes your technology better. It makes your employees better. It makes your employees happier. It delivers value to your business. Again, profitability, productivity, market share.
What's the most common pitfall organizations fall into in this area?
So I think there are a couple. So one is not measuring the things that matter, right? So we have, like, sometimes it's just local optimizations, right? Sometimes people are like, I'm gonna do CI, you know, continuous integration, or I'm gonna do continuous delivery because continuous delivery. And then they just get spun up on something, right? Or they'll measure something because it's, like, convenient or easy. And then it shows up on a report and that's all they pay attention
Correct.
To. And I'm sure you've seen that.
Oh, 100 times.
Right?
And then, you know, and there are even things that I've asked to be measured and then realize it was the wrong things.
Which is fine, because it's continuous improvement, continuous
Correct.
Learning.
Correct.
So then, you can still keep it if you want, but at least pull it off the report.
Yeah, but start measuring, and
yep.
then you're gonna realize that, you know, you're gonna get better. Just the numbers, when you first start doing the measurement, the numbers are gonna be dirty, they're not gonna be clean.
Realize the power of an honest baseline.
That's right.
If it's bad, that's even better, because you have nowhere to go but up.
At least you got a place to start from.
Yes.
You know, and that has been this journey, I think, that many of us have gone through, that it is all about, you know, getting started, and then constantly learning, constantly getting better, constantly refining. But
and it gives you something to talk about and communicate about.
Oh, yeah.
Suddenly, if you're on a different team, you, like, I can talk to you about it. And, like, if I think your performance or your metrics or your something sucks, like, that's okay, because I have something to talk about.
Correct.
Instead of, like, yelling at you, we can yell about the thing.
It makes it tangible and real. You can have a conversation and then
right.
say, okay, now how are we gonna go get better on this?
Exactly.
Next time on Brad Anderson's Lunch Break.
If you wanna be, like, super capitalistic about it, we find so much research everywhere showing that diversity of background, diversity of thought, diversity of gender, diversity of race, diversity of all the things leads to better outcomes. You make better products, you build better software, you get better outcomes. It's worth the investment.